But
yeah, so you have taken the screenshot.
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so how the assignment will be like? Build the model first. Okay, first we will build the model, then we will vary the parameters. We will build the model in such a way that the parameters will be able to, we can vary like mass, we can vary spring constant, we can vary, and damping constant, we can vary these things, we can vary. Okay, then coming to the, this will be the first part. Okay.
Okay.
Then coming to the second part is like varying using the M script. Okay, this we will be doing manually, this first part, but this will be, we will be using an M script, and that M script will do the simulation for multiple parameter and will try to plot the data. Okay. Then the second step is to create it through the GUI. Okay, so this will cover some maximum part of whatever is left behind. And we will also cover the plot part also here, the remaining plot part. Okay. This was an empty file or?
No. Yes.
Okay, okay. Or maybe we will create a new file. You can close this one and go inside the folder in which the model is there.
Okay.
Double click on the that folder. Double click.
Mm.
Okay. Right click here and create a new model. Maybe plus new. Yeah. That one model. Okay. Yeah, save this model with some name, maybe mass temper, MSD.
Yes. Mm.
Yeah, double enter maybe. You cannot use hyphen, I think underscore you can use.
Right.
So can you open this? Yeah. So can you open the equation that you have taken the screenshot? First, we will look into that. Okay, in here, what is the system equation? X double dot equal to F by M, okay, minus K by M into X, and C by M into X dot. Right.
Right.
So yeah, we need to multiply something, right? And to add, and we need to integrate. So all those relevant blocks we need to first add into this one. So go to your model. Go to your model. Type in the space. Yeah, maybe. Yeah, you can keep it side by side if you want. Windows right arrow key also you can use. Windows right arrow key and Windows left arrow key for like this maybe. Okay, so so click on the white space and type gain, G-A-I-N, gain. Yeah, gain block you need. Click on the gain. Okay. Then you need add block. Find add block. Then you need integration block. Integrate the first one, I think. Yeah. Okay. And then you need input block, because force is the input input, or maybe you can use a sine wave. Sine wave you use, that will be the input, like, or step. You use step, yeah. Oh, with that also we will use one step function, step, yeah, step, yeah. Okay, we will use both how it will be, and use switch. Can you use manual switch? manual switch. Yeah, manual switch. Okay, so this will we will use for some other purpose. Okay, so all these are ready. Now what is actually you need to do, you need to have like the right hand side green circle part, right? So those are those parameters will be there in the gain block. So there are three circles, so you need to duplicate three times the gain block. Yeah. So three gain blocks, and inside that you can type like F is the input. Okay, F is the input, then in that case maybe you don't need that as gain block, you need to have it as a product block. Or yeah, there you can use 1/m, first one 1/m, double click 1/m, yeah, write 1/m, yeah. Yeah, done. No, you need to apply. There is a apply. Yeah, apply. Okay, yeah, it will be red only because that M is not defined. Yeah, then K/m. Okay, yeah, apply. Okay, yeah, then C/m. Yeah, done. Gains are all done. Then what you need, you have how many additions are there? First term is plus, second term is minus, third term is minus. So you need to have three operations. Yeah, double click on that one. First will be plus. First will be plus. No, double click on that block. Yeah. First will be plus, second will be minus, and third will be minus. Yeah, enter. Okay, so little increase the height of the block. So that you can add signals properly. Yeah, may move them to the left side, gain blocks, little left. So at the rightmost side, what you can do, you keep the add block. Okay, add block at the rightmost side. Keep add block on the rightmost side. Yeah. So here, what is the first term? That is F/m, right? F is the input, right? So here in this case, we will use sign or step as the input. So can you place sign and step one below another? Yeah, one below another on the left hand side. Totally on the left hand side. Yeah, there. Okay. Keep the manual switch in between them. Like little, yeah, there. Yeah, little more left. Little down. Yeah. Okay. So connect both of them to the switch 1/1 port. No, the other side, back end. You connect to one sign and one to wave. Yeah. There. So that we will change input and we'll decide how it is behaving. Next, into the system, what is first input? That is force F/m, like it is going. So input is F/m. F could be either a sine wave or it could be a step function. So the output of the switch will be going into the 1/m. Okay, can you connect to the gain 1/m output of the switch? 1/m. Okay. it is being multiplied. Now you drag the 1 by m into the below part in front of the drag that block into in front of the switch. We will keep in an organized way. Yeah, little yeah. Okay, so this is 1 by m which is going in, and it will be added. So can you connect 1 by m directly to the add plus? Okay, so this is can you drag the plus means the block a little down? Yeah, not there, far, little far right side. Yeah, yeah, delete that line. Yeah, that is we have not created. Okay, now C by M. Okay, C by M should be multiplied with what? X, right?
Yes.
C by M should be multiplied with, can you check the equation? It should be multiplied with X or X dot? X dot.
Into X dot.
Okay, so what is the output of the equation? X double dot, right?
Right.
Yeah, so in the add output should be a X double dot, right? Add output should be X double dot. So what you can do, when there is double dot, if you integrate, then one dot will reduce. Okay, so what you can do now, you keep your K by M and C by M into left corner, anywhere on the corner. Yeah. Okay. Now you drag your integration block. Before that, you rotate it. Yeah, rotate that. Yeah, rotate that two times just to reverse the direction. Control R. One more time. Okay, now it is being reversed. So we need X and X dot, right?
Yes.
We need X and X dot. So maybe you can rotate it as it was previously. That will be better. Okay. So yeah. Now what is the output of the add block? X double dot, right? So connect the X double dot, which is the output of the add block, into the integrator input from the add output to integrator input. Add output. Output, you bring the arrow from add output. Yeah, the, from there to integrator input. Input, not output. Yeah, there. Okay, so this represents what is coming out from the integrator. X dot, right?
Yes.
Add is giving X double dot. Can you double click on the signal that is coming out of add and name it as X underscore double dot. Double dot. D-O-U-B-L-E dot. D-O-U-B-L-E. No. D-O-U-B-L-E. Underscore dot. Okay, this is X double dot. Okay, so what is coming out from the integrator? It is X dot.